Now, is it a ringing indictment of the PlayStation 5 and the new generation overall that the most anticipated game on the platform is a game from the year 2009?
Or
is it a testament to the enduring popularity and legacy of Demon's Souls that the most anticipated game on the platform is indeed one from 2009? The answer, of course, is both. Demon's Souls is a very excellent game, one of my favourites. I've been clamouring for a re-release for years. There is a damn good reason this has been such an anticipated release. There's a damn good reason that the handful of non-automated human beings able to get their hands on a PlayStation 5 are making Demon's Souls their first purchase. It's because Demon's Souls is chuffing brilliant, and the Demon's Souls remake is, well, I mean, it's Demon's Souls, so it's pretty damn brilliant. Bluepoint's done a really good job of resurrecting this PS3 classic, the cult hit that led, of course, to the ever so much more popular Dark Souls series. Now that Dark Souls and Bloodborne have become such household names, hopefully the re-release of Demon's Souls will get it in front of a lot more eyeballs. It's certainly gotten itself a lot more press, because while reviewers at the time were really high on Demon's Souls, it didn't reach that more mainstream audience that its descendants enjoyed. For Demon's Souls itself, this is a huge creative victory. Getting what Demon's Souls did in front of more people is fantastic. Demon's Souls deserves as many eyeballs on it as possible. It deserves just as much attention as Dark Souls got. In fact, for my money, Demon's Souls has some of the most atmospheric and moody environments in the entire series. Some of the very best stuff. Dark Souls and Bloodborne took so many design cues from Demon's Souls. I mean, obviously, Demon's Souls is the progenitor of Soulsborne stuff. But even going back to Demon's Souls after going through every Dark Souls game and Bloodborne, there's still a freshness in the world of Boletaria that shines through in every single level. The poison-soaked nightmare that is Dark Souls' Blight Town may be the most famous, but nothing matches the sheer level of filth and depravity and squalor that is Demon's Souls' Valley of Defilement. One thing I've always loved about the Soulsborne series is how the bleakness of the world manages to evoke a sense of beauty and history among all of the rubble and the ruin. Something that seeps gorgeously from every crack in the wall of the Boletarian Palace. With constant despairing and creepy background noises, with a lavishly detailed scenery and moody lighting, Demon's Souls' oppressively evocative design effortlessly showcases how and why it influenced an entire smash hit series. The gameplay of the original remains largely unchanged in the remake. If you've ever played a Dark Souls game, you've got the basic idea already. You slowly pick your way through intricately designed levels, sometimes unlocking shortcuts, although Demon's Souls is a lot harsher about that element than Dark Souls ever was. Bluepoint's modernized some elements, added a few quality of life changes, one of the most dramatic being omnidirectional rolling. You can actually roll in 8 directions now rather than just the 4 that you could do in the original Demon's Souls, which, you know, is really bloody useful. If you want to check up on world tendency, it's quicker and easier to do that. World tendency being something that affects various events and difficulty levels in each world based on your actions. There's a menu that far more clearly tells you what each world's tendency is, although the symbols used can be a little hard to distinguish. Plus some new items and weapons and rebalanced drop rates and that super secret door that people found that behind. There are some lovely new animations for the weapons. Weapons now have these lovely parry and backstab animations for some really devastating finishing moves. A few elements have been balanced. For example, you now can't wander around carrying infinite amount of healing items. You're limited in the amount of healing grass you can carry about. You'll simply get bogged down if you try and bring too much healing with you. Though really not to any degree that you'll feel particularly restricted. More than 20 full moon grass is probably gonna be enough. The game looks absolutely gorgeous. Of course, it's not the most visually impressive PS5 game that goes to Godfall, but it's a way better game than bloody Godfall. Playing it at a full 60 frames per second is very nice. The bleakly pretty environments look real good in 4K. And on a technical note, it's really hard not to appreciate those loading times, being able to take you from the Nexus to an in-game world in a matter of seconds instead of minutes. Nice. The voice cast for the original characters are mostly back and have redone their lines and are really good. They're really good at their lines, which is good. I'll just say good again. And the NPCs now have facial animations, including Patches, who looks like a complete slimy goober. And I mean that as a compliment, not to Patches, but to the animation work. And I'll just say this on a personal note, I really do appreciate the non-gendered body parts with character creation, so I can make a non-binary character and dress them in the non-binary finery that so speaks to my own personal style. One controversial change has been to the user interface. It's a lot more cleaner now. It looks a lot less artistically thematic. Some people don't like how plain and utilitarian it looks. But I'm pretty sure the last time I played Demon's Souls was in 2010, so I can't bloody remember the UI off the top of my head. It wasn't so memorable or iconic that I'm lamenting its loss right now. I didn't notice it while I was playing until it was pointed out after the fact. It's not that big a deal. And, you know, the rest of the game looks so gorgeous. The UI getting in the way of that isn't a big loss, I don't think. Most criticisms I have of the game are largely applicable to the rest of the series. The issue with your weapons bashing against walls in tight spaces is especially noticeable in this game due to the prevalence of tight spaces. And they really, really, by this point, should have been able to sort out better online. It's already a convoluted process to get any form of co-op or versus going. The lack of reliable connection or stability that crops up at this point is It's fucking irritating. Bluepoint's done an excellent job of updating Demon's Souls so that it feels more in line with the games it inspired, while still retaining the mechanics, the gameplay, the atmosphere that made the original so beloved. It didn't take long for me to become as obsessively absorbed in this game as I was way back in 2009 when it first came out. And I did my little trek to the shop to see if they had one, and I had to ask, have you got one? Have you got Demon's Souls? And they said, yes, it's over here. It's not on the shelf. It's over here. And I got the one that came in that little slip case, and it had a book with it and a soundtrack. And the book was basically a guide for like the first quarter of the game, if not the first half. And it told you all sorts of cool stuff. It was basically cheating, which you can also still do if you get the deluxe edition of this game. Not because it gives you a guide, but because it just gives you some shit that will absolutely wreck everything in the beginning goings. But isn't that video games these days? An increasingly desperate and flimsy push for ever more expensive special editions while raising base game prices. Demon's Souls also has photo mode, which not everyone's gonna love to take advantage of, but it's definitely worth checking out. You can do different poses and facial expressions, you know, all of the stuff you'd expect to see in a photo mode. Plus, unlike anything else in the Soul series, it pauses the game. On a more generalized note about the PS5, I do appreciate the sharing options it has. You know, it really improved the overall share function, and photo mode seems to be coming as more of a standard in video games. I'm pretty cool with that. Plus, it can pause the game. For any Souls fan, the Demon's Souls remake is, of course, a no-brainer purchase. For anyone new to the series, this is as good a point to jump in as any. I mean, without Estus Flask, being able to carry 20-odd fucking healing items is gonna make this one probably a touch more accessible. It is indeed sort of an indictment of the PlayStation 5 that the most exciting PlayStation 5 game is a 2009 PlayStation 3 game. But as I stated at the top of this presentation, for that's what it is, Demon's Souls status as a new gen must-have is a well-deserved compliment to the game itself. Yes, the game is officially 65 years old. Yes, it's from two generations ago. But this PlayStation 3 game is the best PlayStation 5 game. And if you have one of those huge plastic butt magnets, well, do you need me to recommend it? Or are you playing it already? Because you're probably playing it already. What else did you get a PS5 for?